ISUPK.
Until when the year is over, right? The so-called year of the white man is over. It's the holiday season, right? And everybody's preparing for that, right? They've been preparing since they started advertising it at the end of Halloween, right? They followed it up with the turkey, right? Everybody went home. Everybody celebrated Thanksgiving with their family at the big turkey. You know what I'm saying? All the food on the table. You understand? But what about the origins of that holiday? Does anybody know about it?
Yeah.
Anybody know about it?
Yeah.
The origins of Thanksgiving is nothing more than the mass murder genocide that white people did to the Native American Indians.
Right.
You understand? The mass genocide that they did to the Cherokee, to the Sioux, to the Choctaw, you understand? To the Native American Indians. And every time they killed one of my family members, they went home and celebrated and said Thanksgiving. We got to give thanks that we killed some Indians. You understand? White people are the devil that the Bible speaks of.
Right.
They got a horrible day coming in the day of the Lord. You understand? White people, them so-called Jewish people are saddened because Hitler killed a multitude of them. But more than 77 million Native American Indians, which outweighs them damn so-called Jewish people, were killed. You understand? Family members destroyed. They've been doing that since the 1400s. Ever since they came to America and stole the land and started killing the natives and lying and saying that they discovered America. You understand? God damn America. God damn everything that America stands for. The flag, the I Pledge Allegiance, all of it. You understand? We should not be celebrating Thanksgiving. You understand? We should not be celebrating any of these damn holidays that the white man has set up. You understand? All these holidays, Christmas, New Year's, Thanksgiving, Easter, what else? Veterans Day. Labor Day, Valentine's Day, all of it, we should not be celebrating it. You understand? The fact that we're celebrating it shows that we still are in captivity, that we still are slaves, and we want to celebrate whatever master celebrates, we want to celebrate. But let's find out, according to the Bible, how God feels about Thanksgiving, how God feels about New Year's, how God feels about Christmas. Let's find out. Get to Jeremiah. Jeremiah, the 10th chapter. You don't mind if I can get that little, you understand? Can I get that sand right here? We gotta make an example, right? They say you need examples to teach.
From here.
You understand? We're gonna show you what God said about these holidays. The Christmas hope, the whole concept of Christmas originates in Babylon. You understand? The whole thing, the Christmas tree and all that. When you do the research, you'll find out that Christmas is a wicked holiday set up by the damn white man. You understand? There's no such thing as a fat pig like this coming down a black man's chimney. A Hispanic man, Native American Indian man chimney. Because the white man labels that as breaking and entering, right? Is that not what it's called? When you enter into a man's house uninvited, breaking and entering. But on one day of the year, the December 25th, it's okay to let this pig come down the chimney, right? Come down and put gifts. Come down and Yuletide carols and eggnogs and sing the Christmas carols and all that, right? It's okay, right? Because the white man says so. The hell with Christmas. You can take your Christmas back. You can take your Saint Nick back. You can take all of it back. You understand? We still slaves in America. We don't need to celebrate any filthy, disgusting holidays that the white man has set up. You understand? It's all evil. We're going to show it to you in the Bible. Read.
The book of Jeremiah, chapter 10, verse 1. Hear ye the word which the Lord speaketh unto you.
You understand? Right here in the book of Jeremiah, another black man who was a prophet by the name of Jeremiah. And he said, read it again.
Hear ye the word which the Lord speaketh unto you.
Understand the Lord speaking unto black people, Hispanics, and Native American Indians. Who we are? The Israelites of the Bible. He's speaking to us. Read.
O house of Israel.
What?
O house of Israel.
You understand? I just told you he's speaking to black people. I just told you he's speaking to black people. Read.
Thus saith the Lord.
Thus saith who?
The Lord.
Thus saith me.
The Lord.
I say it you.
The Lord.
I say the ISUPK.
The Lord.
The Lord is saying it. Read.
Learn not the way of the heathen.
Hold on. What did God say?
Learn not the way of the heathen.
What are some of the ways of the heathens? Homosexuality is the way of the heathen. Lesbianism is the way of the heathen. You understand? Eating crab, pork, shrimp, crab, lobster, all of that is the way of the heathen. Celebrating your birthday is the way of the heathen. Celebrating Easter is the way of the heathen. You understand? Celebrating goddamn Christmas is the way of the heathen. That has nothing to do with us. You understand? God said, learn not the way of the heathen. You understand? The way of the heathen get black people killed. Get black people molested. Get our children raped. Get our women raped. Because we want to learn the way of the heathen. And God specifically told black people, learn not the way of the heathen. Read.
And be not dismayed.
Be not dismayed. Don't be surprised. Why? Read.
At the signs of heaven.
At the signs of heaven. Because these other heathens, they'll look up at whatever coming out the sky and start to fascinate over it. Start to now want to divide in their mind. And maybe it's a sign somewhere, and it's a sign of divinity, and they need to go worship it. You understand? God said not to be dismayed at it. Read.
For the heathens are dismayed.
Well, it's clearly telling us the heathens are dismayed. Who are some of the heathens? If you don't know, black man, the white man is a heathen. The Chinese and Japanese and East Indians and Polynesians and Africans, those are heathens. Read.
For the customs of the people are vain.
Are what?
Are vain.
Are what?
Are vain.
What is Christmas?
Vain.
What is Halloween?
Vain.
What is Thanksgiving?
Vain.
What is your birthday?
Vain.
Vain. You understand? What does the word vain mean? It means useless. It means worthless. And guess what? The white man set up a system where we gotta spend all our money to buy some stupid gifts. You understand? Just to please who? To please your family? Now think about that. Are you truly pleasing the family or are you truly pleasing the white man?
That's right.
It's more like we pleasing the white man, because guess what? At the end of Halloween, what did they do? They start pushing the Christmas events and the Christmas sales and the Yuletide carols and the songs behind it. You understand? And all the Christian hymns that go with it. God said, the ways of the heathen are vain. They are useless. They are worthless. They are dead. Read.
For one cutteth a tree.
Hey, listen, now hold up. Now it's time to use our head. Now it's time to start thinking about what the Lord is saying. For one cutteth a tree. Now I don't know about you, but every time I go to the Home Depot or I go to some major supermarket, they always cut out a section like Walmart and put up fences. And what do they start rolling in? Trees that were cut down. Read.
Out of the forest.
Where?
Out of the forest.
Out of the forest. Now we know, black people, we don't own a damn lick of land in America. We don't own forests. Somebody's going out there and chopping these trees up. You understand? Who's the culprit? The same culprit that started the whole thing, the white man. He the devil that the Bible speaks of. It's all a marketing scheme. Go out in this forest, cut down these trees, go up into the black neighborhood and sell it all to them. Because they believe in the Saint Nicks. They believe in the white Christmas. They believe in snowmans and Jack Frost and all that stupidity. The elves, you know, and the red-nosed reindeer, you know what I'm saying? And the jingle bells. You understand? All that. Black people believe that wholeheartedly. And guess what? We push it on our children. We say what? It's just for the children. Meanwhile, what we're not realizing is we're teaching our children to comply with the white man's holidays. So that way when they grow up, they'll teach their children and say the same thing that we said. Well, it's just for the children. It's just for the kids. They grow up into adults, teach the kids the same thing, and so on, and so on, and so on. And the cycle keeps going. Meanwhile, we get more broke than a little bit. You understand? This year, black people, let's not do it. But the Lord said, for one cutteth a tree out of the forest, read.
The work of the hands of the workmen.
The work of the hands of the workmen. Somebody got to go labor in the forest to cut down the tree. Read.
With the axe.
With what?
With the axe.
Letting us know it's an axe. You understand? You can equate also a chainsaw today. Same thing. Read.
Verse 4. They deck it with silver.
What?
They deck it with silver.
Hold up. Hold up. We got a tree that came out the forest that was cut down by a worker who used an axe. Went and took it, and now the people bought it and deck it with silver. Read.
And with gold.
And with what?
And with gold.
Go to the National Mall. And I bet you right now, there's a big tree with all kinds of decorations. They got gold, and they got silver tassels on it. And lights, it make it look like a big spectacular. You understand? Looking wonderful. Go to 30 Rockefeller in New York. 30 Rockefeller, you understand? And they got the Christmas tree lighting right there in front of the ice skating rink. It's a grand big tree being in that building. Somebody go work it and put gold and silver on it. Read.
They fasten it with nails.
What?
With nails.
They fasten it with nails. Read. I'm gonna give you that. Read.
And with hammers.
With hammers. Meaning this tree, they have a Christmas tree stand, right? Back then, they used to put cross on two panels and nail them and fasten it so that way it won't tilt back and forth. Today, you plant it on a Christmas tree stand. Read.
That it move not.
Why is the Lord saying that it move not? Let's think about that. Here you have a tree that came from a forest that was chopped down by a person who used an axe. They took it. They went and put, they nailed it with hammers, right? And they built a stand for it. They decked it in gold and silver, but it's saying that it moved not. Why is that? I'm going to tell you why. Because back then, during the Babylonian Empire, when Nimrod died, his wife declared that the evergreen tree was Nimrod. And if you don't bring the gifts, we're going to chop your heads off and put it as ornaments on this damn tree. So a lot of people believe that the Christmas tree was alive. But God said, what?
They fastened it with nails and with hammers, that it moved not.
And it moved not. A Christmas tree is not alive. You understand? It does not move. You understand? It don't move. And it ain't going to haunt you. It ain't going to kill you. You know what I'm saying? It ain't going to destroy you, the tree. What will destroy you is the celebration of Christmas. That's what will destroy black families. You understand? We want to hurt the white man so bad, let's hurt him in his pockets. You understand? That's how you hurt white society. No guns, no weapons could ever hurt the white man. You understand? But what will hurt the white man is his economy. You listen, you don't believe me? Go to Wall Street, and every time something happens in Wall Street that affects their money, some white man swearing he's Superman jump off the 18th floor because he can't take the fact that now he's going to the poorhouse like with black people and Hispanics and Native American Indians. He can't take it. He don't know what it's like to really truly be at the bottom. You understand? Being oppressed, being looked down upon. He don't understand that. So he throws himself out of an 18-story window, take a dive, boof, that's the end of his problems. You understand? But meanwhile, blacks and Hispanics and Native American Indians, we gotta suffer this hell we call America. We gotta suffer this hell we call the white man oppressing us. You understand? God said that it is not alive. Is there any more?
They are upright.
They are upright, meaning they straight up read.
As the palm.
Just like the palm tree. They are upright. Read.
But speak not.
A what?
But speak not.
Understand? The Christmas tree does not say a damn thing because it's not alive. You understand? The whole concept of the Christmas tree come out the Babylonian Empire. Do your research, you'll find out that the Christmas tree go date back all the way then. And Saramesses was her name, the mother and lover of her own son, Nimrod. Said that it was Nimrod in that tree. And then it would speak to you and curse you. And if you did not put ornaments, you died. Is that the end of the verse? Okay.
Be not afraid of them.
God wants us not to be afraid of them. Read.
For they cannot do evil.
What?
For they cannot do evil.
You understand? This tree can't do no evil. Read.
Neither also is it in them to do good.
Neither also is it in them to do good. You know why? Because it's not alive. It doesn't do nothing. Just stand there and collect dust. And while it's adorned in glittering gold and silver and ornaments and all that, it looks beautiful. But the reality is, all it's doing is running up your light bill. That's all a Christmas tree does, is run your light bill up. You understand? With all the lights and all the fascination about Christmas, all it does is make you waste more money. And having black people been on the bottom too long, it's hard for black people to make some money. It's hard for black people to save money. It's hard for black people to make ends meet. It's hard for black people to pay a bill. But now think about all that. If it's hard for all these things, why the hell we want to celebrate something that the white men say we should celebrate? You understand? Let's get some more. Let's go to 2 Kings. 2 Kings, the 17th chapter and the 17th verse. Can I get, if I could, can I get that? I'm going to show you something today. A lot of people don't know, a lot of people don't know this image right here. Right? A lot of people don't know who he is. It's an old ancient icon. And as y'all can tell, it's a black man. Yeah. They get this bastard right here, St. Nicholas, from a real black man who was called St. Nicholas. He cared about black children, you understand, in a black society in Europe. You understand? The whole concept of Santa Claus in a red suit, we clearly see where they got that from. Look at it. This is one of our forefathers, a black man by the name of St. Nicholas. The white man done whitewashed this image and gave us this thing right here. This child molester, slacking. This child molester. This pedophile. This rapist of little boys and little girls. This raper of culture called Santa Claus. Ho, ho, ho. Merry Christmas, Mr. White Man. goddamn Christmas. You understand? Goddamn all your holidays. It means nothing. It's a worthless event. Nothing more than a marketing scheme. And I know some Christian will run into church and do a Christmas mass like the way the Catholics do. You understand? To hell with Christmas. Let me get spoiler eyes for 2 Kings 17 and 17. 2 Kings 17 and verse 17. Read.
2 Kings 17 verse 17. And they caused their sons and daughters to pass through the fire.
Guess what? When we celebrate all these holidays, Christmas, right? Because we love saying Christmas is for the children. We don't realize we causing our kids to pass through the fire. Back then, that was literal because we were serving other gods. Today, how do we do that? By teaching them a goddamn lie. By teaching them about some white devil dressed in a red suit with a beard, breaking and entering and eating milk and cookies and bringing all types of gifts, riding on some stupid reindeer with a red nose that light up the sky and lands on your roof and gives you gifts, and have elves in the workshop making toys. You see how stupid and retarded that is? You see how dumb that is? No such thing. No such thing as Santa Claus. But we make our kids walk through the fire. Read.
And use divination and enchantment.
Divination is another way of saying, I'm going to put it to you in today's term, being a psychic. You ever heard it? Psychic, they tell you future. They tell you what's going to go happen. You understand? We do that to our kids, and we use all these kind of things. Stay up. You understand? When we ain't supposed to do anything like that. Read.
And sold themselves to do evil in the...
And what?
And sold themselves.
And sold ourselves to do what?
To do evil in the sight of the Lord.
See that? We sell ourselves all the time. In other words, how we say that today? The Bible says sold yourselves. How we say that today? We sell out to do evil in the eyes of God. Black people, Hispanic, and Native American Indians, they don't know that Christmas is not real. We'll quickly sell ourselves just for the little feeling of the Christmas holiday, just for the Yuletide carols, just for eggnogs, you understand, and the little old Santa Claus. I be seeing these sisters line up to have their kids sitting on Santa. And I walk with my daughter and I tell her, she's 4 years old, I tell her, you will never ever sit on that child molester's lap.
That's right.
Ever.
That's right.
That's
right.
That's what I tell
that's
my daughter.
Right. That's right.
You understand?
The truth must be told.
Because Santa Claus is a monster. You understand? I make my daughter realize Santa Claus is a monster.
That's
and
right.
You will never do what all of our brothers and sisters thinking in their minds that they are doing some right thing when the Lord said that we sell ourselves to do evil in the eyes of the Most High. You understand?
Right.
Celebrating Christmas, we will celebrate New Year's after that.
Right.
We just celebrated Thanksgiving,
right.
You understand?
Right.
And when the white man up and ready said, when the white man is ready, he'll say, let's celebrate Easter also. You understand? Well, we should not do that.
That's right.
Read.
And sold themselves to do evil in the sight of the Lord.
We sell out to do evil in the sight of the Lord. Read.
To provoke him to anger.
Hold up. And we got to understand this. When we celebrate Christmas, you don't think God get pissed off? You don't think it upset the Most High? You don't think it make him mad? If you don't believe it, turn on the news the next day. You hear all the stories coming out of Chicago, the shootouts that happened on Christmas Day. The events that happened in some barrio up in Manhattan, you understand, on some reservation, how somebody committed suicide on Christmas Day, or somebody got raped in church doing a Christmas mass. Go and turn on the news. You'll find out that God was pissed off at black people. You understand? He get mad at us. Yeah. We got to realize there's consequences.
Right.
Deadly consequences for celebrating Christmas.
Right.
You understand? It's real serious out here.
That's right.
Read.
Therefore, the Lord was very angry with Israel.
No, he was just a little bit angry. It's okay. I know you're depressed. Go ahead and get your Christmas groove on.
Right.
Nah, he said what?
The Lord was very angry with Israel.
You understand? God was very angry with black people and Hispanics and Native American Indians. He's very angry at Israel. You understand? And guess what? If he's angry at us, there's somebody to blame also. Our leadership should be teaching us these things. Not to celebrate Christmas. Not to celebrate any of these holidays. You understand? Not to do it. Because the Lord get very angry. Read.
And remove them out of his sight.
What? And did what?
And remove them out of his sight.
You understand? That's a black man talking right there.
Yeah.
If you don't know, this is an old Greek and English version of slang talk. Today in America, we say, man, get out of here. Get the out of here. You understand? I don't want to say the word. You know what I'm saying? That's how God got pissed off at me. Get us out of our sight. So much so that where we ended up. We ended up in the cargo slave ships. To do what? Our final destination was to go pick sugar cane, go pick cotton, go serve the white man and flip burgers in McDonald's, or go work in Congress and be a good old mammy for the white man. So that way we can hear, get the Christmas bonus, and they tell us Merry Christmas all the time. You understand? For what? You still gonna be black in America. We still gonna be black in America. We still gonna be at the bottom of society. What we thinking that because blacks and Hispanics celebrating Christmas, that's gonna give us favor to the white man? I don't think so. We still gonna get shot by police. After Christmas, on Christmas, before Christmas, we gonna get hurt. You understand? Only one way to reverse that hurt, and it's to turn back, change our lives, and serve the Most High, and recognize who we are. And that is right, brother. And after we do all those things, separate from the white man. When I mean separate, I mean stop loving the white man. Stop giving all your money to the white man. Stop hugging on the white man like he's something worth it. God calls the white people a no people. Now feel that for a second. God don't even consider white people people. You understand? He calls them spit in the Bible. Now feel that. So we're going to celebrate the holiday of a people who God considers spit. Think about that. We're celebrating Easter because the white man say so.
Right.
We're celebrating New Year's because the white man say so.
Right.
We're celebrating our birthdays because the white man say so. And he spit in the eyes of God. Well, maybe we should do something different.
Yeah.
Maybe we should listen to a black man by the name of Jesus Christ,
right,
who also calls white people spit, and change our lives,
right,
and come back and serve our God,
right,
and do what's right in the eyes of the Lord instead of evil in the eyes of the Lord. So that way, maybe he'll say, I told you before, get out of my face, but now guess what?
Right.
Come back home.
Uh-huh.
It's time we go back home, black people. It's time we come back.